Hi students, I think you are getting ready to learn social science. I know you all love this subject because this is the only subject in which you can learn about all the things that had happened in the past. In today's class, we are going to learn about our Earth. This lesson is a conversation between a boy who is studying in 5th standard and his father. His name is Imayan. He is waiting for his father to come home. After his father came, Imayan tells his father about what had happened in the school and what did he do in the school. The boy tells his father to help him to draw solar system because his teacher is going to teach about the solar system in the next class. So student, shall we also join with them to know about our Earth? Imayan became very curious and started asking questions about the solar nebula and how the Earth is formed. Solar nebula is a cloud of dust and gas. Many billions of years ago, an explosion, that is a shattering, was caused. The small particles collapsed and stuck together and fused to make bigger chunks. But this does not stop until they had created a hemisphere which revolve around the sun and is called planets. Thus the planet is formed. Students, have a look at the solar nebula. What you see here is a galaxy. Galaxy is a group of stars or cluster of stars. Milky Way. The Milky Way is a part of galaxy. They are huge collection of stars, gas, dust and other materials. Imayan and his father had a chat for a while. Then Imayan asked about the universe. Students, can we also join them to know about the universe? Yes, it is a vast expansion of space. It consists of a huge group of stars and all the 8 planets. Students, I am going to say you something interesting about the solar system. All the planets revolve around the sun in different orbits. Mercury is the smallest planet in the solar system. As Mercury is nearest to the sun, it is extremely hot during the day and extremely cold during the night. The second planet is Venus. It is hottest and biggest of all. It can be seen in morning and in evening. Third is our planet Earth. It is the only planet which life is known to exist. Fourth planet is Mars or red planet because of the presence of red salt and rocks. Fifth and largest planet is Jupiter. It is so large that it can occupy the Earth. Sixth planet is Saturn, second largest planet in the solar system. Seventh planet is yellowish in color. It has beautiful ring outside. Neptune is the 8th planet. It is the furthest known planet from the sun. Imayan, the curious little boy, asked his father about the Earth movements. His father started explaining. The Earth has 2 movements, that is rotation and revolution. Rotation. The movement of the Earth on its axis is called rotation of the Earth. It causes day and night. Revolution. The movement of the Earth around the sun on its axis is called revolution. Seasons are caused by Earth revolution. Summer, winter, southwest monsoon, northeast monsoon. Life is possible only on the Earth because of the presence of land, air and water. We have 7 continents, 5 oceans. Okay. The 7 continents are Asia, Africa, Antarctica, Australia, North America, South America and Europe. The five oceans are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Thus the boy moved happily to study.
Now children, we can watch a video related to this lesson.
Earth is the third planet from the sun. The shape of the earth is an oblate sphere, which means that it is flattened at the top and wide near the middle. The diameter of the earth from the top to the bottom is shorter than the diameter across the earth. This means the earth is an oblate sphere. Among the other planets, Jupiter is the largest planet and Mercury is the smallest planet. Continents are the very large land masses on the Earth's surface. There are 7 continents in the world. Oceans are extremely large water bodies of salty water. They cover 3/4 of the Earth's surface. There are 5 oceans in the world. The stiff, outermost rocky layer of the earth on which we live is called the crust. It is made of many sections. The continents are located on these sections. The constant movement of the continents is called continental drift. Initially, joined together as part of one big piece, continental drift has moved the continents to their current positions. A set of planets continuously moving around a star is called a planetary system. Our planetary system is called the solar system. Our solar system is made up of the sun, 8 planets, their satellites, and other heavenly bodies. A planet is a very big ball-shaped object found in space. A star is a burning ball-shaped object in space. It is very hot. The moon is the natural satellite of the Earth. A natural satellite is a ball-shaped object which travels around a planet. Natural satellites do not have their own light. They reflect the light of the sun. Natural objects found in space, such as rocks, are called asteroids and meteors. The rocks floating between Mars and Jupiter make up the asteroid belt. A comet is a small burning object that passes through the solar system again and again. Comets are commonly known as shooting stars. A famous comet is a Halley's comet. The Sun, the Earth, and neighboring planets are part of larger groups of heavenly bodies. A collection of many planetary systems and clouds of gas and dust is called a galaxy. There are uncountable galaxies. The name of our galaxy is the Milky Way. Earth is unique as it is the only planet where living things are found. The Earth is therefore called the living planet. Venus is the hottest planet, while Neptune is the coldest planet in our solar system. The first person to travel into space was Yuri Gagarin from Russia in 1961. Rakesh Sharma was the first Indian to travel into space. The moon is the only heavenly body that people have traveled to.
Students, I hope you all understood about Earth. Catch you in the next class. Thank you.